Avran, good morning.
Morning, Avran.
Good morning, good morning.
Avran, I really enjoyed last night. The first goal for me was crucial. If Chelsea got it, I thought, lovely, we have a game on here. And it was a beautiful move, Frank, to the left-hand side. Ramirez picks out Drogba, good finish, perfect start.
Oh, the goal was brilliant, brilliant. You know, the right moment, and he showed something about the old players of Chelsea. Frank, the brilliant ball to Ramirez. And Drogba, like Drogba in big games, great finishing.
Yeah. Interesting as well, Di Matteo was saying that, you know, the old guys, if you like, John Terry, Drogba, Frank, prove people wrong that, you know, they can still do it on the big occasions. Of course they can. And he was proved right, I thought, all three last night. Drogba with the goal, Frank battled away. John Terry, the semi-final FA Cup and last night again, brilliant. The times that Avran, John Terry gets in the way, blocking, final tackles, the times he does it, it's not luck, is it? It's not luck.
John Terry was great yesterday. So, because when you play against Barcelona, it's very difficult. It's not just marking. You need to be very clever to be in the line of the pass always, and to read the passes, and to be in the right place. It just, and blocking, of course. And if you see what John Terry did yesterday, you know, every pass to the box, he read it. He was in the right place in the right time many times. And you know that Barcelona, and of course Barcelona creates some chances, but I think John was very good, and he played with a player that is not so experienced in big games, gave him, you know, a lot of confidence. I think that John, Frank, and Didier was very good yesterday.
Avram, so trying to get in the head of Roberto Di Matteo here. You've been there trying to keep the job at Chelsea, you know, trying to get to a Champions League final. What do you think he's got to do to keep the job at Chelsea full time? Has he got to win the Champions League final, or has he just got to get there?
To be fair, I don't know. I don't know, because sometimes you don't know. Even I know the owner very well. You don't know what his calculation and what he's seeing for the future. When I was there, it was not just we came to Champions League final and we beat Liverpool that lost 2 times before in the semi-final. And also, we played very good games, won all the big games and a good football before. And then still it was a rumor that even if I take the Champions League, I will not continue. I don't know. I think Roberto needs to continue with his good job that he's doing. It's not so easy. And what will happen will happen. I don't think there is any criterion of who will be the next manager of Chelsea for the moment.
Avran, you're 1-0 up. You have to go to the new camp. Will it be the same again tactically for Chelsea? If you were in charge, would you be trying to flood the midfield again, sit back, let them have the ball? And it was for me, it was evident last night, Avran, set pieces, long throw-ins, balls in the box. Chelsea can. They're a taller, bigger side than Barcelona. And I think that's where the threat could be. So is it going to be a game of patience, try and frustrate them at the Nou Camp?
I think you're absolutely right. You said everything. Because when you play against Barcelona, Chelsea today, I don't think they're in good shape anyway to move the ball and pass the ball, which is anyway difficult against Barcelona, because Barcelona now is not just a team that know how to pass the ball, also the team that press about the midfield player, don't let you to make so many possessions and something like this. But 1-0 at home, I can tell you from my experience, is the best result that you can get, because Chelsea, in any case, deserve a away goal in Barcelona. First, they've Chelsea, quick players in the attack in Barcelona are not so great against counter-attack. And the second, like you said, Barcelona is not so great against set pieces, especially the Chelsea have a good player, so there is a good delivery.
Yeah.
So I think in this case, it will be more difficult for Barcelona than to Chelsea, because Chelsea can score away goals and then Barcelona needs to score 3. And it's not too easy.
Mm. Avram, you've worked with Didier Drogba. As you said, you know, a brilliant goal, the way he puts himself a bit. He does frustrate a lot of people. He goes down very easy. But is that a tactic against Barcelona, just to try and break their play up?
first about Didier, I told you, I think we already spoke. If you check the percentage of how many big games Drogba is good at scoring, you will be, it's amazing. He almost always good in big games. If you remember, just 4 years ago, the same date, I think, 18th of April, semi-final that we played against Liverpool, tough opponent to score. He scored 2 goals against them. He always good in a big game. And, you know, you need these players for big games. I think Didier is a player that is good when you have possession, also good when you have counter attack. Very difficult to stop him.